What's up, guys? The 2019 NFL offseason is done for, and it's time to get ready for some football. As we inch closer to week one, it's a fun time to take a look at some of the biggest offseason moves, from coaching hires to blockbuster trades to the draft. You name it. Obviously, most of us think the New York Giants messed up by trading Odell Beckham Jr. and selecting Daniel Jones too early. Those moves already look extremely regrettable. Here, we're looking at moves that look genius from the get-go, ones that were mostly praised by the football universe. But if you examine more closely, you'll find the red flags. And we're here to tell you why we think these moves could backfire mightily. I'm Jason Biondo, and today we present 10 NFL offseason moves these teams may end up regretting in 2019. Don't forget to subscribe to TPS and put on your notifications, because we post videos all the time. Subscribe. Number 10, New York Jets signed CJ Mosley. The New York Jets had bundles and bundles of cap space, so former GM Mike Maccagnan was able to overpay for a couple of high-priced free agents. That said, he overpaid four-time Pro Bowl linebacker CJ Mosley big time. It was a five-year deal worth $85 million. Mosley is a game changer on defense and renowned leadership on and off the field, but inside linebackers simply aren't worth that much money. And you have to think, if the Jets waited it out, they could have gotten Mosley for less. Down the road, this team's gonna have to give monster extensions to Sam Darnold, Leonard Williams, Quinnen Williams, and Jamal Adams. Even if Mosley plays up to his usual standards, it's going to be hard to justify every penny of that $85 million deal. It wouldn't be a surprise if it took the Jets just one season to realize their mistake. Number 9, Oakland Raiders draft Josh Jacobs. Tons of experts predicted that the Oakland Raiders would take Alabama running back Josh Jacobs in the first round. And that's exactly what head coach John Gruden and general manager Mike Mayock did. They took Jacobs with the number 24 pick, adding another potentially explosive playmaker to a revamped offense. But are the Raiders sure this was the right pick to make? This was a draft with many solid running backs. Lots of them didn't go until the third round, and the Raiders have holes all over the roster, especially in the secondary and on the offensive line. Jacobs was a stud running back in Alabama, but so was Trent Richardson. And how did that work out for him? Jacobs won't be much of an impact player unless the Raiders' O-line has a complete turnaround. The Raiders like Jacobs and his playmaking abilities, but if the team continues to plummet and sink in the standings, the front office and coaching staff will be kicking themselves for using a valuable first rounder on a running back. Number 8, Baltimore Ravens sign Earl Thomas. Okay, so we've only had nice things to say about the Baltimore Ravens' decision to sign Pro Bowl safety Earl Thomas to a four-year deal worth $55 million. When healthy, this man is arguably the NFL's best defensive back. He's a world-class talent and future Hall of Famer. It's that simple. Thomas joins a Baltimore defense that allowed the fewest yards and the second fewest points per game. If he stays healthy, Thomas should be a huge addition to arguably the best defense in the entire NFL. But there is a concern here. Thomas is entering his age 30 season. He had a fractured fibula injury that ended his 2016 campaign. He suffered a broken leg in week 4 of last season, once again ending Thomas' year abruptly. Oh, and the Ravens released Pro Bowl safety Eric Weddle so that they can make room for Thomas. Thing is, Weddle was still playing at a top-tier level in Baltimore. The Ravens are giving $55 million for what could be a very small upgrade, or even a downgrade. That's the risk here. But for the Ravens, the potential rewards were too great. They need Thomas to stay healthy, fit their system, and continue to play at a Pro Bowl level. Otherwise, the front office will wish they had just kept Weddle the entire time. Number 7, Denver Broncos trade for Joe Flacco. A hip injury combined with poor play forced Joe Flacco to finish his Ravens tenure on the bench. Rookie quarterback Lamar Jackson took over as the starter while Flacco was hurt, and he never looked back. The QB-desperate Denver Broncos traded for Flacco in the offseason, sending a fourth-round pick to the Ravens. The Broncos then drafted Missouri quarterback Drew Locke in the second round. With that, they have two starting-caliber quarterbacks to work with. But the Broncos might regret trading for Flacco, because he's done little to indicate that he's still an average to above-average quarterback. In fact, many believe the Ravens waited way too long to move on from him. A fourth-round pick is a decent price to pay for an aging and oft-injured quarterback. The Broncos haven't been able to find a reliable starter since Peyton Manning retired in 2016. And if the Flacco project fails in the Mile High City, well, who knows how many more chances Mr. Elway will have to fix this team. Number 6, Cleveland Browns make Freddie Kitchens head coach. The Browns mercilessly fired Hugh Jackson after an embarrassing start during the 2018 season. Greg Williams took over as the interim head coach, but was not renewed. Anyone on to become the defensive coordinator of the New York Jets. Running backs coach Freddie Kitchens finished out 2018 as an offensive coordinator, taking over for the fire Todd Haley. The Browns decided to hand him the head coaching reins after the season, rather than going with a top-tier candidate like Mike McCarthy. Now, Kitchens probably deserves a look after helping rookie QB Baker Mayfield go on a tear to finish the season. But are the Browns sure that they want to give a young guy with no head coaching experience the top gig here? That remains to be seen. If anything, the Browns could have retained Kitchens as their OC, and then hired a new head coach. But they put all their eggs in one basket, and the pressure is on Kitchens to take Cleveland to the playoffs. Anything less will not be acceptable with the star-studded roster that their front office has assembled for him. Like, if you have this many good players, like, they're literally so good, if you can't make the playoffs, at least the playoffs with them, you're doing something wrong. So hopefully this will go well for the Browns. But again, there's a lot of risk in hiring Kitchens as head coach. This could go very well for Cleveland, or very poorly. There will be no in between. We'll find out soon enough if they end up regretting the decision to promote Kitchens here. Number 5, Jacksonville Jaguars sign Nick Foles. The Jaguars went from AFC runner-ups in 2017 to dead last in a tough AFC South division in 2018. Tom Coughlin and David Caldwell didn't want to waste any more time, so they cut Blake Bortles and signed Super Bowl 52 champion and MVP Nick Foles to a 4-year, $88 million contract. Foles reunites with John DeFilippo, who served as his quarterback's coach when he led the Philadelphia Eagles to the Super Bowl. So that's good, for sure. But my God, this signing simply has to work out for Jacksonville, because there are no other reliable options out there. They're simply not bad enough to tank for one of the top quarterbacks in the 2019 draft. It's Foles or bust. That's it. We don't think Foles will be terrible in Jacksonville. We're not saying that. But he has to take this team to the playoffs. His stats may not be as pretty as they were in Philly. The Jaguars don't care. They just need Foles, who's a major upgrade over Bortles, to take Jacksonville to the promised land. They are sick and tired of waiting, and honestly, the fans are too. If 1 year in Jacksonville is a disaster for Foles, the Jaguars will be looking at a ton of changes all over. Now, you gotta give them time to adapt, but they won't be able to cut him or trade that hefty contract. They just have to sit back and hope for the best, because if Foles doesn't pan out, they're going to regret this contract for a long time. Number 4, Oakland Raiders trade for Antonio Brown. Many have criticized the Pittsburgh Steelers for getting lowballed when they traded all-pro wideout Antonio Brown to the Raiders for nothing more than a 3rd and 5th round draft choice. Not a great return for a guy who's good for over 100 catches and well over 1,000 yards a season. But the Raiders might regret trading for Brown. He's entering his age 31 season, and going from Ben Roethlisberger to Derek Carr isn't exactly inspiring. Big Ben is a future Hall of Famer and perennial MVP candidate. Carr is pretty much fighting for his future as a Raider, so yeah, not the best. Not to mention that Brown created a lot of drama on his way out of Pittsburgh. Might he do the same in Oakland? Gruden does love his character players, but even the model and classy Steelers organization couldn't get AB to behave himself. Imagine they still had Khalil Mack and Amari Cooper and Dan Antonio Brown. Wow, that'd be a team. The price to acquire Brown wasn't bad, but there's a chance he fails to produce. It cost them a lot of money, and it brings more problems into an already tense locker room. Maybe the Steelers would be the ones who get the last laugh. Number 3, Miami Dolphins trade for Josh Rosen. I mean, Josh Rosen only lasted just one season with the Arizona Cardinals, as the 2018 first round pick was traded to the Miami Dolphins in exchange for the 2019 second, plus a 2020 fifth round selection. Now the deal looks like a coup for the Dolphins, who needed to find a new franchise QB after trading Ryan Tannehill to the Tennessee Titans. But the thing is, Rosen might only last 1 or 2 years in Miami. This team is starting off a massive rebuilding project. If they earn a top 5 pick for 2020, it's hard to see them not taking one of the many top QB prospects. Miami has a good chance at winning the first overall pick, so the Dolphins could very well have surrendered a second round pick for 1 year of Rosen. And with little talent to work with in Miami, it's gonna be tough for Rosen to succeed. This trade could either make the Dolphins' future, or it could set them back. They just might end up regretting this one, but who knows? Number 2, New York Jets sign Le'Veon Bell. We've raved about this move a plenty already, but maybe the Jets will regret dishing out $52.5 million to Pro Bowl running back Le'Veon Bell. Why? Well, people don't need to be reminded about how easy it is to find a good running back these days. For starters, it was reported that new head coach Adam Gase was against the idea of former GM Mike Maccagnan handing out that much money to one running back. Maccagnan was fired weeks after the draft, amid rumors that he and Gase weren't seeing eye to eye. So now what happens if Bell and Gase can't play nicely and get the ball rolling? That's gonna create more unnecessary drama in New York. Gase is practically being forced to use Bell as much as he can because of all the money he's being paid. I mean, Bell's great, but he still has to use him because of the money. Plus, you know, Bell did sit out the entire 2018 season, so you can expect some rust. On top of that, Bell was on a stacked Pittsburgh Steelers team that has one of the NFL's best offensive lines, especially when it comes to run blocking. The same cannot be said about the Jets unit. Now, we still think Bell will shine and be a fine weapon for young quarterback Sam Darnold to work with, but there is a ton of risk in handing out this much money to a running back, and it sounds like Gase didn't even want him that much. As you know, the Jets are experts in creating unnecessary disasters and turmoil in their own locker room. This could end up being another example of that. Hopefully not, though. We'll see. Number 1, Arizona Cardinals take Kyler Murray first overall. The Cardinals were supposed to build their franchise around the aforementioned Josh Rosen, but they couldn't resist the temptation of taking Heisman Trophy winner Kyler Murray with the first overall selection. Now, Murray's overall athleticism and skill set cannot be questioned, but he also has a very high bust potential, like most dual-threat quarterbacks. He could shine like Michael Vick and Cam Newton, or he could flop like Jamarcus Russell and Robert Griffin III. But then again, RG3 only flopped because of bad management and coaching, so that's a whole different thing. Murray's height and size are concerning to scouts, although Drew Brees and Russell Wilson have turned out fine. But will Murray be able to withstand so many hits? Will he be able to adapt to the professional level? And will his accuracy and delivery get better? Those are a ton of questions he must answer soon. And new head coach Cliff Kingsbury is no guarantee to succeed in the NFL. Moving out Rosen and drafting Murray might be the move that saves the Arizona franchise. It's also the one that could set them back even further. They might only need 1 year to realize if this was a smart move, or a regrettable one. What other offensive moves do you think teams may regret in 2019? Join me in the comment section below. You know what else you should do? Make sure to follow myself and TPS on social media, because like, we post great content all the time. I post videos on my YouTube channel, and we post funny tweets and Instagrams, so go follow us. Subscribe, do the whole thing. Also subscribe to TPS, because if you haven't already, you get sports content all the time, so why would you not want to subscribe? Make sure to like this video, because I know you liked it. You have nothing to lose here, just like it, takes one click. Of course, thank you so much for watching. I'm Jason Biondo. I'll see you next time.